To set up virtual office hours in Canvas, begin by clicking Conferences in the course menu. I'd give it an A. The solution for hosting the conference is called Big Blue Button. You can record this conference, but the shelf life of the recording is only 2 weeks. And I would choose no time limit. And when you instantiate this conference, it will automatically invite all course members with an email. So click Update. And to start the Virtual Office Hours conference, you click Start. So the rest of this is going to be just a demonstration to show you the ropes. The conference will load. You will be prompted to join the audio by clicking microphone, and you'll be prompted to allow your microphone to be used, and then you'll hear an echo in your ear, which means that the microphone is working, so click yes. And you were told you're the only person at the conference. That's fine. Your microphone is activated. Notice that when you move your mouse over the microphone icon, you can mute your microphone and unmute it. That's important, which I will explain a little bit later. To start your webcam, go ahead and click the webcam icon, and you will be prompted again to allow the webcam. The webcam will open, and there you are. You can change your webcam settings. You can make the image even larger, but let's go ahead and stick with 320 by 240 and click Start Sharing. Now, there's my image in the lower left-hand corner in the webcam panel. Above it is the Users panel, where you can see people who have logged in. You have a Presentation panel where you can load a PowerPoint. As you can see, these controls, this panel is pretty busy with information. And there's a chat window where you can type messages to whomever is logged in. Or do I mean whoever? Whatever. Click Send. You can even change the layout to video chat, which is kind of cool. And you'll see this view populate with others who are logged into the meeting. And they, too, will be prompted to use their microphone and their video camera, just as you were when you entered the meeting. So obviously you have to make sure that you have a webcam and a microphone in good working order. I like to use this type of solution because it's plug and play. I have earphones on, so there's no possibility of feedback, which can be kind of annoying. And it's just very simple. This type of system, plug and play with a USB connection, you can get for less than $40 at your local office supply store. Microsoft Live Chat is an example. So is Logitech. There are lots of examples that are out there. So I'm going to go back to the default layout. And the thing about the muting is this. When you have a number of people who have logged into your meeting and they've all got microphones on, there is the possibility of feedback. Some students just won't be using earphones. I would direct them to mute their microphone unless they're talking. And that would be a courtesy to everybody in the room so as to not have feedback. You can disengage the microphone by clicking Stop Sharing Your Microphone and turn your microphone back on by clicking the same icon. That's about it for virtual office hours. I think that's pretty much it in a nutshell.